We've got a brand new topic now. Let's start talking about XY plots. Now you may be familiar with these from, social science is fond of these things. You have a series of data, income and education by sample size of 10. You plot them together. We have education versus income. You end up seeing correlations like this. It's also called a scatter plot. Now, of course, you can do the same thing with process data. We do this support for this in ProcessBook through this XYPlot. So if I click on this XYPlot button or choose Draw XYPlot, I can then try to find out what the correlation is between, two process variables. So for example, I'm going to look at BATemp.1. That's a temperature, and that's going to be my x-axis. As you can see, you have radio buttons there to choose that. I'm going to plot that against CDT 158. That's going to be basically the y-axis part of this, and let me just go ahead and complete this so you can show what we show, just off the right off the bat with the defaults. What we're showing here is the temperature plotted across the bottom, the other variable CDT 158 plotted across the y-axis. And what we're doing is reporting the y coefficient right up here. So this is an inverse correlation. As the temperature increases, the CDT 158 decreases. We see the inverse correlation. It's a strong r coefficient, 0.7, to indicate that there's a strong relationship between the two. So some of the things that we didn't point out when I was doing this is, first of all, you can, many cases you like to turn these scatter plots so that they're just showing the data, not the lines. So one of the things you can do is, remove the connecting lines, remove the grids, and you have something that looks a little bit more like a traditional scatter plot. Now I can also look at how the data is aligned in this instance by double-clicking right up here where the title would normally appear. Let me go ahead and put in a plot title, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So let's put in a title. Title goes here. As you can see, this area right in here, if you double click on that, it's going to go ahead and launch this statistics. So it's telling us, for example, how many items in this sample and what the coefficient of correlation is, what the slope is, etc. But you can also look at the raw data for both pi tags involved. So here's my x-axis. Let's look at the y-axis. We're going to see we've correlated these in time, 345 to 345, 355 to 355, etc. So as we're going forward in time, we're taking the x value, we're plotting against the y value. Now, if you're familiar with pi data collection, you'll recognize that this seems a little odd. It would be the wildest of coincidences if there's actually an archive value at 515, 525, 535 for each and every one of these. So in fact, what we're doing is, by default, we're interpolating values. As you can see right here, we're choosing the interpolate method. We're doing this at 10-minute intervals. So I end up with 49 values. If I were to change this to, say, 20-minute intervals, we would end up with fewer in this sample. As you can see, fewer dots. And now there's only 25 instead of 49. So the idea here is that this interval determines, that interval essentially determines what your sample population is going to be if you choose interpolated. Now you have other options. What you could do is you can just say, let's do recorded data. What that's simply going to do is find all the recorded values for BATemp1, and it will synchronize the Y tag to those recorded values. So in this case, let's look at the grand finale here, the end result here. Is if we look at the data, we're seeing, let's put both of these on here now. Yes, we're seeing that every single value, 353, 357, 59, 409, these are the actual archive values of the tag on the x-axis, the temperature. What we're doing is we are interpolating a synchronized value for that timestamp. So 409 to 409, 429 to 429, these are not at evenly spaced intervals. They're at the intervals of the occurrence of data on the tag on the x-axis. So these are some things, these are some of the options you have. In addition to synchronizing, you could also specify that we do some, well, some things that don't make any sense. For example, you can say interpolate, in which now we're comparing the recorded values against the interpolated values. It doesn't make much sense to do that in this instance because, of course, they're all going to be in non-matching timestamps. One of the other things you can do is do a match, which indicates that it's only going to compare when there's a complete match, when both of them have a value at exactly the same timestamp. And in fact, it looks like there are a few instances of that here. If we look at the data again, let's look at the two next to each other. Yeah, for most of the sample size, there is no corresponding data. But yeah, still no corresponding data. But occasionally, yes, there we go, we see just a few instances where at exactly the same moment in time, there was a value for both. So we've tried to make this flexible enough that depending on what your requirements are, what your reporting requirements may be, or just what your standards are for doing this calculation, you have the option to do that. Now, as you can see, you also have the option here to change which one is the X and which one is the Y using this radio button. And we do support adding multiple trends on here. You don't have to have just comparing temperature against one variable. And finally, the XY plot allows you to do a type of a cross-correlation where you're comparing these two variables, but not for the same period of time. Let me give you an example. If I set BA temp to interpolated values, and this is also at interpolated values, but at different times. For example, let's say we suspect that the temperature is a leading indicator, temperature is a lagging indicator by about an hour. We can say, let's go with yesterday plus 7 hours to yesterday plus 15 hours. That's the 7 to 3. That's for the x-axis, the temperature. But then here we'll go yesterday plus 8 hours, y plus 8 hours, to y plus 16 hours. Now, since it's the same interval, it's the same number of interpolated values, but it's for a different period of time. So we're suspecting this is a leading, this is a lagging indicator. Let's see if there is a coefficient of correlation. And it's apparently my guess was wrong. This coefficient of correlation indicates no correlation at all. And if we compare the individual values by hovering over here, you can see, take a look at the timestamp. It's 350 compared to 250. Okay, on the x-axis or the y-axis versus the x-axis. So if we go through these, you'll see all of these are offset exactly 1 hour, 11:30 to 10:30. And if we look at the actual set of data, we'll see that same thing. So it's a nice opportunity to do an interesting kind of a cross-correlation, 7:40, 8:40, 7:50, 8:50, et cetera. And you know, by being able to do this so simply, you can find correlations that may not have been apparent. Now, for more information on the formatting options available, just take a look in your Pi Process Book User Guide. You'll find this in Chapter 6 on XYplots.